For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that SELinux. What does mean by the SELinux and how that SELinux will give you a enhanced security protection on your machine. So how that works and how it's going to be useful for your environment. Okay, so example, see that SELinux in the sense security enhanced Linux. So which has basically basically most of the questions comes like if you already have the firewall, why you need a Linux SELinux, or you already have the SELinux, or why you need the firewall. So in security, there is no any software or any device does not provide you the 100% security, or there is some security loopholes, okay, in all the things. But if you use multi-level of security systems, example that in edge of your network you use the firewall, in the system level you use the firewall, and the system level you use the SELinux security, and file level you restrict the permission, so that certain security can be provided to the systems using the systems, so that our important things will be protected against hackers or malicious software things, something like that. So that's why we can use firewall. We also have to use the SELinux or different things, but the SELinux will provide you the different levels of security enhancements. In like it can be switched on like port level security, like particular port, if you are mapping to the particular service, then you can enable that level. Or if you are starting some services, then you can enable the service level, and you can also enable this SELinux on the file level as well. So which means that three layers of security the SELinux can provide, but the firewall can only protect on the port level. Like if the port is allowed, the firewall does not look that traffic which is coming the allowed port, because it is allowed. But in this case, SELinux, which means that if you allow the port 80, but still if the traffic is coming inside the 80 and trying to access the other services which are not contexted to that particular service, then what it says that it block your service. Okay, so that is the SELinux. So the SELinux has the three modes. One is enforcing mode, the next one is permissive mode, and last one is disabled mode. So what does mean by these three modes, and how these three modes can help the system? So enforcing, in the sense the policies, whatever the policies you defined on the system. So example, say that /etc/SELinux, and there is a file called config. In this configuration file, there is a policies. See this targeted policy and the minimum policy and the MLS, multi-level security protection, and modification of target policy. Only selected processes are protected and target processes are protected. So you can enable any of this one, but by default the targeted is enabled. SELinux type is by default. So which means here, if enforcing, in the sense the SELinux policy is enforced, which means that is SELinux is switched on and it is looking for all the services which are already targeted. So if any of the file level times are not matched, then it blocks that service. It does not allow any other user to come inside and access that services. Okay, permissive in the sense it does not disable, or it does not restrict the users. Okay, it allows, but it only records the information on the log. That's it. It does not do anything permissive in a sense. Then disabled also looks similar, but it does not warn or it does not do anything. It just simply disabled policies. In the sense, no security is provided whenever the SELinux is disabled. In the sense, no security is enforcing you to stop to access that machine. Okay, if some service is compromised, then using that service they can go into the home folders, or they can go into the different location, they can access the files. But in case of SELinux is in enforcing mode, if one service is compromised, the service level, whatever the files are accessible, they can only access those files. But other than those files, with our other contexted files, which is example that if your HTTP is compromised, but if you are accessing the FTP folders, FTP related files, so the security will stop. In the sense, the SELinux will stop based on its context. So how the context here? So example, say if you say ls-lz, z is the parameter which show you context. Okay, so here you can see that this is the context of the SELinux. Okay, so what does mean by this context over here? So let's see that. So the first one, unconfigured, unconfined underscore u, which means that is a SELinux user based context. The next one is the role context, role based context, and this is RBAC, role based access control. And this one is the type, okay, which type of the context over here. And the next one is the level, which level of the SELinux context is going to be provided over here. S0 in the sense, let's say simple context. So here these levels can be configured on the over here, like /etc/SELinux. Okay, in this there is a configuration files. Okay, so wherever you enable the policies over here, so here is the things, you can see this. So multi-categorized security level tables over here, so which is already defined over here. You see that offset can be categorized from 0 to 1023 categories defined by the admin. So here what we do here over is that define once, administratively define once, and the same definition, whatever you define, it will be defined system wide, not for the particular things. Okay, you can also define particular things, or you can define entirely for the system. So here S0 in the sense system low, S0 minus S0 or C0 are to system low to system high, or S0 or C0 to system high. So C1023 in the sense the system is very high security level is configured. If you configure that, you have to be very careful in configuring each and every configuration file. If you misplace some of the context, or if you misplace one of the user level context, or row level context, or the types, or level of security you enabled, which means that the SELinux security does not allow even you the other files which you define other than the service. So that's why you have to be very careful whenever you are configuring. SELinux is configured, or why the SELinux should be used if you have the other services. So the SELinux policies administratively defined and enforced the system wide. Okay, which means that it will be once administratively defined, and it's available enforcing for the all the system wide files and the services and ports will be protected against the any attacks or the any context which are not matching the labels. Okay, so basically the SELinux is more improved on the RHCL7 or the CentOS 7 versions. And however, the SELinux is not an antivirus software or the any replacement for the passwords or the firewalls or the security systems. Okay, along with the SELinux, you have to use those like password security levels and firewalls and security systems, whatever you are using. Okay, and example say that if you want to see a SELinux architecture, the SELinux architecture is defined as I shown you in the before, like I'm just switching back to the root user in order to show you. So first of all, you have to see that get enforce. So which means that SELinux status, how, what is the SELinux status currently? It is, it is enforcing, or is it permissive, or it is any disabled or something like that. You can also see, if you want to see the details, see status, okay, enter, then you can see that in detailed information about the SELinux status. Example say that SELinux status is enabled or disabled, is enabled, and file is enabled, and the directory level it is enabled, and the policy loaded is targeted, and the current mode, which means that the current mode is enabled also, and the, from the configuration file also it is enforcing, and the policy target status is MLS, in the sense multi-level security is enabled. The policy deny unknown status is allowed, which means that any deny unknown status, which means that deny any unknown configured file system, simply deny it. Okay, maximum kernel level policies version is 28. So the SELinux is not only configured on the levels which are not the system levels or the configuration files. The SELinux is by default load the from the kernel level access operations on the systems, which means that whenever the system boots, the SELinux will be put the hook on all the files and things using the context. Okay, so let's see that how you can switch over these modes. Example say, if you say get enforce, which means that you get that which is enforcing. If you want to set to the permissive, you can simply say that set enforce to 0, and now you can go and see that the Linux SELinux has been changed to permissive mode, which means that the permissive mode will allow you to do anything but which logs the logs on the audit logs or the messages, like SELinux is access these files, this file is allowed, this file is not allowed, but the users are able to access the files, just it reports, that's it, it does not do anything. But if you say enforce equal to 1, which means that this SELinux is in still enforcing mode, so that the SELinux cannot allow other services which are not configured properly or which is not labeled properly on the system. So how you can go and see that different labels. Okay, simply say ls-ldz say slash root, okay, which is actually labeled with the admin underscore home underscore t, which means that the type of the SELinux context is defined already, which means that, and if you see, go ahead and see, like slash usr, so this has the different context over here, or if you go and see that where it has the different context, and if you go and see whether they, okay, I do not have any FTP or www service, okay, maybe we can install it later, but if you go to home, then you can see that home underscore root underscore t, and if you see maybe the etc, so etc underscore t, maybe if you see different files, example say slash etc slash password file, so like this you have the different context, so that the service can only access based on that context is matching in the, or the label is matching. If you type the different commands, or if you are trying to access this password file with the different commands, then it does not allow you to get into that file or change anything on that file, because it is not matched your context with the password file type. Or if you are accessing the user home directory from the HTTP protocol, which does not allow you to access, because the slash home folder is not typed as a HTTP example. Okay, example, I am installing httpd over here. For the best example, we can see on the httpd or ftp, things like that. Okay, let's see that. So my http is enable system and say start httpd service. Okay, and ls-ldz, see that slash var www html is the directory which is enabled as a httpd sys underscore content underscore t, which means that which can be allowed to browse from the web browser service using the httpd service. Okay, example, say that I'm just stopping this system cte, or we just allow that firewall -cmd -permanent -add the service equal to http and https. Okay, firewall -cmd and reload the service, so which will not disturb our things. Okay, so now if I go to cd slash var wwhtml, and here I just create some file called index.html, because that is SELinux testing, something like this I have written, or SELinux testing from web. Okay, now if I open any of the browser over here and type what is that IP address. Okay, so this is the IP address of the machine, and go and see over here, enter. Now you are able to access, because the SELinux context is defined as a httpd context, right? But then it will not allow you to enter into that service itself. What it says that your example, say mkdir test ls-ldz, let's see that test directory, what is the context you get over here. See this httpd context you get. That's why the httpd context will allow automatically to browse your things. But if you define the context over here, example, say that let's define some context over here. Let's say I'm just defining over here that chown, it's a temporary definition over here. So I'm just changing that httpd context underscore t to something else over here. Maybe I'm going to change etc underscore t over here. I'm just changing. Okay, so maybe the security level is s0, and I'm changing to index.html and ls-ld. So maybe I'll change all this context etc underscore t and see this file. Okay, now ls-lz and see that index.html is changed to etc underscore t. Now I'm not doing any restart over there or service restart, nothing. Just go and see over here, refresh this service. Oh, which is allowing. Okay, so some CTL, and let's restart the service over here. And now go and see this. What happens? You're not getting that file. So what you are getting over here, and maybe if we go to something like slash test, so nothing over here, right? But if you create this file, example, say that go to test over here and create some index.html and say testing SELinux. Right now, if you go to this file and see SELinux, right? But if you change the context of that file, this file, now just restart the service to effect currently. Now go and refresh. What happens? Do not have the permissions to access this test because the SELinux is enforcing you to stop these things. Now the same you can see on the slash var log messages, and maybe you can grep for HTTPD related stuff over here. You can see this HTTPD related context has been seen over here. Like what happened? See this SELinux is preventing HTTPD from getting the access to that file called slash var slash test slash HTML file, right? Which we are trying to access. But if you want to see the details, you can see over here SE alert and thus message over here. Let's see. So it is also show you in detailed information about that which file you are trying to access and which is preventing you all the stuff. But what I'm going to do over here, it is that set enforce equal to 0, which means that it records your messages, but it does not do anything over here. Let's example say that let's watch this file. Okay, let's tail hyphen F over here and just enter. Now I'm trying to access this file over here. Okay, the log will append. Example C, see this, the file is coming, serving the data, it's serving the data, but what happens? It is recording the messages over here. See this, right? So like that, what it will do over here, it is that it will just record. See this, SELinux is preventing HTTPD open access to this file for complete messages. See this, see alert. Okay, like that it is showing you the information, but it is not blocking you. But if you say set enforce equal to 1, which means that now you cannot able to access your things because the context what you set is not matching exactly what you are supposed to match, right? And now we can go and lsf on ldz slash var ww html. You can see that this is the context exactly it should match to that system, that file. Okay, now I'll change that chcon. It's a temporary change. Okay, we are going to do it index.html. now you just restart httpd service to in order to affect that condition. Now you can simply go ahead and see this SELinux is accessible. Now it is accessible, which means that it is permitting you the access to the outside. Like that you can do. So if you are trying to access inside of the other directories which is created or which is simply created somewhere else, and if you move to the same state to the that folder, it does not access, it does not give you the access because it is in a different context. If you want to disable the SELinux completely, so you need to reboot your machine in order to do that. Okay, how you can do that anyway, but if you go to SELinux slash etc SELinux and config file, go over here and say that which is enforcing, to simply say it to disabled, which means that your SELinux is going to be disabled, but which is not disabled currently. You can see that get enforce, so which is still enforcing. But if you go to SE status and see this, the configuration file is disabled, but the current mode is enforcing, which means that currently which is enabled, but the configuration file is disabled. If you restart the machine, what happens? The SELinux is going to be disabled. So that is about the SELinux. I hope you understand, which has the three modes of the Linux, three modes in the Linux. One is enforcing, another is the permissive, and another is the disabled mode. So if you say enforcing, which means that it's fully in enforcing, and the SELinux context are the label match, based on the label matching, the SELinux will allow you to the files will be allowed. So not only in this file level, if you go to the ps-example, say that efz. So here also the SELinux context will be enforced. See this. So in process level it is enforced, in file level it is enforced, and it is also enforced in the service level as well. You can also see the service level also, system ctl status and httpd. So here also the SELinux context is enabled and which is in enforced, which means the service is trying to access from the somewhere else which is not labeled properly, or with the context is not applied properly. The service is still running and the service is okay, which means the file, all the files are okay, configuration is okay, but the SELinux will not allow you to access any of the service related files to the external or the service, because the context is not set properly. Okay, the context is, you can set on the user based and role based and the time or the security level. One more time, I'm just repeating the final time. See this, the file, the first one is the user one, next one is the role, and the third one is the type, and the last one is the level, security level. That is about the SELinux. I hope you understand the SELinux stuff. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask